Does power matter for a hi-fi system? Well, of course it does, because without power, the hi-fi system doesn't work. But that's not really what I mean. Does power matter for sound quality? Does the quality of the power matter or affect the sound quality of a hi-fi system? Yeah, I can see some of you nodding their heads and others among you shaking their heads probably quite furiously. But what about something like this? You know, a typical power strip that we might use in a hi-fi system. Could anything like this that we maybe plug into that power strip affect its sound quality? Furutech are a company that believes, yes, they do, and yes, both of them can. And they contacted me last year and asked me if I'd be interested to look at their brand new product, which is called the Clear Line, that they state is an AC Power Supply Optimiser, all based around NCF technology. And I've already made videos before about other Furutech products that feature NCF. There is a big elephant in the room here. Currently, at the time of making this video, the Furutech Clear Line are only available in either Schuko or US plug varieties. And obviously, I'm based in the UK, so that meant I had to borrow a few different products in order to be able to create this video for you. And I want to say a huge thank you to our friends over at Sound Foundations, who sent me a big box of Furutech goodies, again, to be able to make this video. And because they sent me a few different products, I felt that maybe I would use those to try and look at a few different things in this video to try and add a little bit of extra value for you. And as part of that, there will be quite a few sound comparisons or demonstrations as part of this video. So maybe it'll be a good time to pause the video now and go and grab yourself a really good pair of headphones, if you're not using them already, to monitor the rest of the video. That way you'll definitely get more out of it than just using your phone speakers or definitely some laptop speakers. And this is the hi-fi system I'm using for the demos. And a lot of what you can see is not plugged in, and I apologize if it's confusing, but let me just quickly talk you through the system. From the wall, I'm using a Furutech mains cable, and that will be feeding into one of two different Furutech power strips or power blocks, whatever you like to call them. And from that power block or strip is another Furutech mains cable or a power cable that will be powering an Arcam SA30. Which is our all-in-one hi-fi system, our streamer, our DAC, our pre and power amplifiers. Using the Arcam SA30 allowed me to run a custom Dirac Live calibration on the system to remove the sound of the room just that little bit more than using the 46, I think it is, GRK Acoustics room treatments that are in my main listening room. The Arcam SA30 is powering the excellent Martin Oscar Duo speakers, and I'm using Furutech speaker cables. The subwoofers are not being used. The only other tweak in the system is I'm using an SOTM ISO Cat 6 network isolation transformer. It's quite a simple hi-fi system in some regards, but it's also still a very good one, and it should be more than good enough to test Furutech's Clear Line claims. Try saying that after a few beers. I wasn't sure how best to go about creating this video, what to do first and how to do it. So I thought, why don't we just start simple? Why don't we just look at the core issue that this video is about? Does power affect the sound quality of a hi-fi system? So what I'm going to do is give you a couple of A-B sound comparisons, obviously from the systems. These are recordings taken at ear height at the main listening position, so as close to the truth as I can give you. And all I'm going to do is change the power to the Arcam SA30. While we're talking about recordings, the volume of everything in this video is level matched. So the amplifier volume is consistent, the recording levels were consistent, and everything's been level matched in post-production. So here we go.
Tonight, I want to give it all to you. In the darkness, there's so much I want to do. so much I wanna do.
Have it. What did you think? Obviously, let me know down below in the comments section. I think it's really quite clear, and you can see why Furutech feel that power is important, because it does make a difference to the sound of a hi-fi system. And this is a nice hi-fi system that I've set up very well, so it sounds good on both different varieties. But for me, every time I listen to the B version of that sound demonstration, there's more detail there, there's more clarity there, and there's more of what makes music engaging and enjoyable to listen to, that extra tone and just the extra quality, among other things. And obviously in the flesh, the difference is quite clearly more dramatic than it will be on the recordings. When I listen to the A version of that A-B comparison in the flesh, the music sounds just toned down. It sounds compressed. It sounds like something sitting itself on the music. With the B version, the system sounds more alive, more expressive. It communicates the musical message, the emotion of the music much more. And I personally much prefer the B version of those two sounds. The astute among you will notice that I actually pulled a fast one there for that A-B comparison. And that is because not only did I change the power block or strip feeding the Arcam with its power, I also added 3 Furutech Clear Line to it. And I did that on purpose to try and obviously grab your attention regards to them, to try and make the difference as great as possible for purposes of doing an A-B comparison on YouTube. But obviously now we need to look at the Clear Line products individually and try and work out, was it those that were changing the sound of the hi-fi system, or was it more the power distribution block that was changing the sound of the system, or was it a combination of both? So what I'm going to do now is give you a set of A-B sound recordings, again, a comparison, but this time I'm going to be using just the silver block on its own, and then I'll add the 3 Furutech Clear Line to see if there's any difference to the sound, really just focusing purely on what the Clear Line might be doing. Here we go. Strangers rushing past, just trying to get home.
Inside me, my world is crumbling.
Interesting, yeah, and I'm definitely interested to see what you guys think. Again, leave your comments down below the video. For me, listening to the recordings and definitely in the flesh, the silver strip on its own, the sound is just a bit more hollow. It's just a bit more vague. And there's like a tinny or a zinginess to the sound that gets removed when we add the clear line. I think adding the three different clear lines, again, it just adds more musical content and fullness and richness and harmonic content to how the hi-fi system sounds. And it definitely sounds closer to how the black power distribution block sounds with the three clear line being added. So I think we can take from that, or I certainly took from that anyway, that the clear line products do work. They definitely do something. Now, obviously, you may prefer the sound with or without the clear lines for the purposes of this sound demonstration in this video. That's not really what's important here. Really what's important is just the fact that they was doing something and that they was changing the sound of the hi-fi system. And up until this point, I haven't told you any details or any technical information or any prices for anything in the video. And that's been totally deliberate because I didn't want to influence you at all. So the Furutech Clear Line is a far more complex product in terms of its design than it initially appears. And if you go to the Furutech website and look at the specification of them, you can see a very detailed description of what goes into one of these. I'll put a link in the video description box, which is obviously down here. If you'd like to go and find out more details about these, I'd suggest go and do the reading for yourself. The Furutech Clear Line costs £230 or about $249 each. The silver power strip is the Furutech ETP66E, and that costs around £350. And the black power block is the Furutech ETP809E NCF, and that costs £3,480. And if you look at them and compare them, you can clearly see there are some very obvious physical differences between them. Some of what is built into the clear line is already built into the black power distribution box. So I thought it would be a really interesting way to finish the video by doing a comparison with the black power distribution block. So again, I'm going to give you a set of recordings with the black power distribution block on its own, and then with the three clear line added to it. And we'll see if there's any difference in sound then. Here we go.
Tonight, I wanna give it all to you. In the darkness, there's so much I wanna do. Made for love. Cause boy, I was made for you.
So there you have it. Obviously, these sound demos are there so you can make up your own mind. You know, what do you think? Do you think there was a difference at all in this situation? Now, in the flesh, the difference is definitely less marked with the black power distribution system than it is with the silver one. And I think we probably would expect that given what we just spoke about, i.e. some of what is in the clear line is already in the black distribution box. For me, when I did obviously my listening, obviously outside of creating this video, I spent a lot of time listening, putting the clear line products into the black distribution box, taking them out, putting them back in. And I found that when they was in the black distribution system, I just preferred the sound of the hi-fi system. I just found the music more engaging to listen to. I found the sound to be just more focused and more tightly packed together. These are the sorts of products that you'll have to try for yourself and listen to see whether they, you know, you feel they add the value that justifies obviously their cost. All I can say is that for me, whenever I've listened to them in the flesh, or even when I've listened to the recordings that I've done for this video, every single time I prefer the sound with the clear line in the system rather than without them. And if they were UK versions that I had here and not Shuko, you know, if I could use them elsewhere, if I could use them in my hi-fi system, then I would do. I would 100% use them every single time going forwards. But again, it's up to you. You need to listen to these for yourself to make your own mind up. I can only give you my opinion, and I feel, yes, they've made a difference every single time and a difference for the positive. Speaking about that, I hope this video has, you know, made a positive or had a positive influence on you. And I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you found it useful and interesting. If you have enjoyed it, make sure you hit the thumbs up button and obviously subscribe to the Pursuit of Perfect System YouTube channel if you haven't already. I want to thank you for watching. Obviously, it's been a longer video. I hope you enjoyed it and I'll see you soon. Take care. Bye.